Good morning. Two people have been killed and a third is fighting for life this morning after a horror crash in Brisbane's Legacy Way tunnel. Claire Todd Hunter reports police are appealing for witnesses to come forward.
Two patients were brought here to the Royal Brisbane and Women's Hospital last night after the multi-vehicle peak hour crash in the busy Legacy Tunnel. One was a woman fighting for life. She remains in a critical condition this morning. The other was in a stable condition with minor injuries. Two people were killed in this incident. One was the driver of a black Audi S3. Witnesses posting online that they'd seen it travelling in excess of 200 kilometres an hour. The other victim, a woman in her 20s, who was a passenger in a silver sedan that was crashed into by the Audi and subsequently slammed into a small truck. The driver of that silver sedan is the woman in a critical condition, the driver of the truck with non-life-threatening injuries. Police want to hear from anyone who saw the Audi travelling on the Centenary Highway.
The matter is currently under investigation. CCTV footage is being reviewed. Anyone who has information is requested to contact police and provide further information, particularly in relation to the driving manner of the black Audi S3.
Police are expected to provide a further update this afternoon.
An investigation is underway into a shooting in Sydney's southwest. Emergency crews rushed to Helens Park after reports of shots fired at a car and house. A dark-coloured Audi sedan was spotted leaving the scene, with police calling on anyone with information to come forward. No one was injured. Loved ones are gathering in Molly Ticehurst's hometown to bid farewell to the 28-year-old mother. Annalise Bolt joins us from Forbes. Annalise, an emotional day ahead.
Yes, Sophie, Molly Ticehurst's alleged murder left an entire nation heartbroken. But it's here in her hometown of Forbes where she'll be farewelled this afternoon by those who loved her most. Family and friends will be gathering here at 2 o'clock today at the local rugby club. And we have just had word that they'll be joined by the state's Premier, Chris Minns. He himself just lost his father following a heart attack yesterday afternoon. The 28-year-old mother was allegedly murdered last week by her ex-boyfriend. He was out on bail despite facing accusations of sexually assaulting and stalking her. She was the 25th woman to allegedly be murdered by a current or former partner this year. It sparked a national outrage. We saw those rallies across the country in towns and cities, and it prompted the federal government to respond with a $1 billion package yesterday, which includes $5,000 payments for survivors who were trying to escape violence. Molly's family and friends, however, want law reform, and they want it written in her name. The proposed Molly's Law would include mandatory ankle bracelets for alleged offenders who are out on bail. They'll be saying goodbye to Molly in just a few hours, but it's safe to say her name won't be forgotten. Sophie?
A difficult day ahead for her family and friends. Annalise, thank you. The AFL will pay tribute to victims of gender-based violence this weekend with a moment's silence. But at the same time, the league is facing questions over the possible return of former North Melbourne player Taryn Thomas. Christina Hearn reports.
Well, last night, monuments around Melbourne, including Flinders Street Station and Federation Square, were lit up in purple. And now the AFL has decided to honour victims of violence against women. So this weekend, players before every match will gather in the middle of the field for a moment's silence. And this will be read out. Enough is enough, and this must stop. Behind every death is a woman who lived and was loved. When it comes to violence against women, the only acceptable figure is zero. But it comes as several clubs expressed interest in former North Melbourne player Taryn Thomas, who was hit with an 18-week ban and dumped from the Roos after being found guilty of multiple incidents of misconduct, including threatening women. It followed previous allegations of offensive behaviour towards women. Here's the Essendon coach.
I've known Taryn since he was 14, and my view is he's a good person. But has he made some terrible mistakes? Yes, he has, and he's the first to admit that. And so as an industry, do we just wash our hands and say we're done with him? Or, do we help him?
It will ultimately be up to the AFL as to whether Taryn Thomas returns to the game, but after taking such a strong stance this weekend, the pressure will be on.
A Queensland man who was extradited to New South Wales over an alleged serious domestic violence incident will face court today. The 52-year-old is accused of intentionally choking and inflicting bodily harm on his alleged victim in Western Sydney earlier this year. Hospitals across the country are in for a $4 billion funding boost from the federal government aimed at easing the pressure on struggling state facilities. Politics reporter Amanda Kopp joins us from Canberra. Amanda, good morning. Is this going to help?
We certainly hope so, Sophie. On the table at the moment is an offer by the Prime Minister to increase Commonwealth funding for hospitals by 13.5% next year. That equates to an extra $4 billion in funding in the next financial year. It includes $1.2 billion to free up hospital beds with financial incentives, which aim to encourage hospitals to move patients facing long-term stays to alternative care. The funding boost is all part of Labor's plan to increase the federal government funding contributions to state and territory hospitals. Announced at the end of last year, Commonwealth contributions will rise from 40% to 45% over the next decade. This all follows a meeting of top health officials from around the country yesterday, as well as ongoing negotiations between the states and territories. Health Minister Mark Butler says the ongoing discussions aren't just about money.
There's a real level of goodwill and cooperation between jurisdictions to explore ways in which we can make our hospitals more efficient, how we can streamline some of the interfaces between the hospital system on the one hand and aged care, disabilities and primary care systems on the other.
Those negotiations between the federal government and the states and territories are scheduled to finalise at the end of June, Sophie.
Amanda Kopp with that update. Thank you. Well, two men have been taken to hospital after a head-on crash in Sydney South. The 55 and 44-year-old drivers suffered injuries to their hips and lower legs at Stony Creek Road in Bexley just before 1 a.m. A major data breach is threatening to expose the personal details of more than 1 million people who have visited RSLs and clubs in New South Wales. Sarah Stewart reports.
Well, the biggest threat today is identity theft, and that is because whenever we see these kind of data breaches, that is when scammers send out emails and text messages trying to prompt people to give them their information or some more money. So the advice this morning is do not respond to any of those, because at the moment, no data has technically been leaked. At the moment, it is being held by some overseas software developers in the Philippines. Now, they worked with a company in Australia developing this technology that you use when you go inside a pub or club. When you enter one of these venues, often you hand over your license, it gets scanned, they have your name, they have your address, they have your photo, and then you have a signature as well. So this is the data that they're holding on to, but they haven't leaked it yet. What they've done at the moment is created a website. You can go onto that website and see if they have your details. If they do, it will show your name at the moment, but it won't show the rest of your details. Everyone is hoping that it is a far as it goes, but there is a fear more will be released because they are in a pay dispute, it is believed, with this Australian company. So for now, the Australian Federal Police is investigating, the cyber crime squad as well. Everyone hoping this is as far as it goes.